Let's have a ball. This is my white-faced male cockatiel, Rocky. He loves to play, have fun, and overall is a wonderful pet. Even though Rowan can be one of the loudest birds, show him, Rowan. Rowan may be one of the loudest birds, but he still loves to have loads of fun, as you can see here. Chloe may call this vivarium her home, but you may be surprised to find out she truly loves the great outdoors. Chloe is very adventurous and loves exploring in wide open spaces. This is Zoe, the newest addition to the Professional Pets family. Isn't she just adorable? So my pets, enjoy the video. Hi everyone, welcome to Professional Pets. Today I'm going to be doing a video on how to clean out your cricket cage, and after you cleaning out, the proper way, or the way I place my crickets in the enclosure. So if you hear me my throat be a little scratchy, it's because I have a cold, and I know a cold in summer is a bummer, but let's continue. So this is the dirty cricket cage. As you can see, there's some dirt, food, dead crickets, egg cartons, paper towel rolls, caps for the food, and it's all dirty. Food spread all over, poop spread all over. So now I'm going to clean this, and these crickets will be going to my leopard gecko, Chloe. So right now I'm going to go dump this, and when I dump it, it'll be not fully clean, and we'll do a proper procedure of cleaning it. Alright, so I'm back, and the cricket cage is back. I'm going to show you what that looks like in a second, but right now I'm just going to let you know two things. If you hear like bird noises, it's my two cockatiels, and if you hear a lady singing opera, it's my neighbor. She just started singing opera, but I closed the door all the way, so hopefully you don't hear it. But for after, I have my cricket water to put in the caps, and actually I forgot the caps, so I'll go get that, and I have the cricket food. I have the crickets from PetSmart. See if you guys can see them. It's a lot in there. I only asked for 30. I think they gave me more by accident. I don't know. And I've got some gloves if I don't feel comfortable with anything, because it is tight dirty. So now we're going to go over to the cage. So this is what the cage looks like. The cage is very dirty. So I'm going to take the cap off. This is the top of the cage. Put that up here. Okay, so now we just have plain filth. Now what are we going to do with it? Are we going to clean it out, or are we going to let it sit there and put more crickets in? I always clean it out after every cricket change. Basically what I do is something called the waterfall method. So I'm going to show you that today. Alright, the waterfall method is simply turning this on. I'm going to try to talk a bit louder because the water, you simply turn that on and you let it get filled. This is in the beginning, so I'm going to let it sit. Not yet. Alright, so now it's filled. Now I'm going to attempt to pick it up without making any spill sounds and messes. But as you can see, that's all water in there. I'm sorry if it's not really a good view. Alright, so now we have this. Now why is it called the waterfall method? Because I'm literally going to dump it into the toilet. I'm literally going to dump it into the toilet. It's not going to be a real dump. It's more of a waterfall. So as you can see now, some of that got out. And I did one side. I did this side, which is basically side A. Now I'm going to turn it around. And now instead of filling up the side that's already clean, I'm going to fill up the side that's dirty, which is side B. Now the two sides on the right and the left here, side here, and side here are side C and D. Side C, side D. So let's just, we have to keep an imaginary spreadsheet or whatever in our minds, and then hopefully we can get to understanding this. So now we're going to look back. Again, that was my bird, if you heard him. Not sure which one. I have two cocktails. But usually I can tell, but I'm sort of focused on the video. So now we have a lot of dirt in here, dead crickets, and now everything's beginning to move around. It's beginning to move around. So, again, a waterfall method. Now here we have side C, side D. This is side C right here. This is side C. So now we're just gonna turn it over. This is a lot to do with the tripod, so the time that you're waiting, I'm sorry. But I hope this is giving you some good information. This is side C. So basically the water goes in from a different angle. With side C, this is basically a fish tank, basically, or a critter keeper, in my case. And you can just let it go here. Don't let it go all the way up to the top, or else you won't be able to get it out. For certain sinks, you can. For this sink, you can't. Alright, so I've been doing this I've had Chloe for over a year, so I'm able to do this pretty simple. So you have all that gook and all that dirt, and now that's all going to go straight into the toilet from the same angle it was put in. And you usually be able to tell because of the mark that the sink might have made. Side D, because I think you guys get it. Don't need to show it again. Now you have side D. Side D is getting filled, and you see that area right there where the water is going in? That's where you can see the mark from the water, so that you know what side you're using. With side A and B, that's not really, it can't apply because this side is so small, so you just have to know. As you can see, we have a dead cricket floating on the right side. Choo, choo, choo. All right. So after we've done all of that, the toilet's gonna get dirty inside. It's going to begin. And you want to do this on the side of the toilet. Excuse me. So now all that dirt has been flushed down memory lane, and now we can just. This is the tank. It's not clean. It is not clean. It's not. So how do we get it clean to the point where we're satisfied? We're going to put soap and we're going to let it sit. So I'm going to go get the soap and I'll be right back. So now I'm going to apply the soap. So I'm just going to go simple like that, a simple squirt. Ooh, bubble. Yes, let me just show you the squirt. And that's it. And now I'm going to go get some. I'm going to fill this up. It doesn't matter which way. Because at this point, we're just trying to get it clean. To the fullest point. You don't want too much soap. That might have been too much. I'm not sure. Alright, so that might have been too much. Hopefully not. Alright, so we're going to let that sit for approximately 15 minutes. And no, you're not going to stay with me for this whole 15 minutes. It's probably not going to be 15. It's probably going to be like 5, 10. So yeah, give or take. As dirty as the tank is, the longer you want to let it sit. This time the tank wasn't that dirty, but I am going to let it sit for approximately 10 minutes. In that 10 minutes, I'm going to go get the bottle caps, the paper towels, and other things like that that need to be taken out. So, yep, that's all. Thank you for watching, and keep watching. Stay tuned, and we're going to get this tank real cleaned up. All right, so that has sat for a while. Okay, so this is all cleaned up. Well, it's not necessarily cleaned up yet. But as you can see in here, it looks like all of it will come out. So I'm just going to simply dump it. Let's get you a view of the toilet. The toiletry. And I'm simply going to dump this out. And that's what we call a lot cleaner. If you're going to use a sponge for your Leopard Gecko's cricket tank, that sponge needs to be different from the sponge that you have for your Leopard Gecko hides, for its food load. So I don't have a sponge for my cricket's tank. I just use paper towel and soap. I don't have a sponge for it, but if you're one of those people that want a sponge for your cricket cage, you're going to need to immediately get two sponges. You're going to need a sponge for your leopard gecko's hides and for its food bowls and for its water bowls and other things that your leopard gecko has. And then you're going to need a separate one for your cricket cage because you shouldn't have the same one. That's like disgusting. So I'm going to empty this some more. So now you see you got less. Oh, my tripod's getting wet. But it's going to get less and less and less and less. The suds are getting less and less and less and less. And it's all getting clean. So what do we do with this? Now, you may think, oh, this doesn't get dirty. Well, crickets can pop. And crickets can pop. So when crickets pop, they ultimately might touch the ceiling, depending on how high their pop was. So it's basically like you're microwaving the crickets. When you microwave popcorn, it pops at a certain level. If you microwave it on low, it's not going to pop that high, probably. If you microwave it on high, it's going to pop extremely high. So we're going to need to clean that out. We just have a little bit of dirt on the bottom, and we're going to get that out in a whoopity-doo moment. But I'm going to rinse this off, so just give me a second. Alright, so that should be perfect. That should be the last clean. And after this, we're going to I'm going to show you the toilet. First, we're going to take an overhead view of this. Not too dirty. Looks a lot better. As you can see, there might be some stuff, like, trying to tilt it up over here on the top of the screen. But we're going to just wipe that with a paper towel. It should be all good. Alright, so now let's look at the toilet, shall we? I'm sorry, so you see a lot of suds and a lot of, you know, suddy stuff that's dirty. Basically, it's like dirty soap, so we're going to flush that. And there it goes. All that sud and stuff is gone, basically. So now, back over here. So I'm going to take a paper towel, my paper towel roll. I'm going to take off maybe two sheets. This is approximately two sheets. If you can see the imaginary line. Well, it's not necessarily imaginary, but it is sort of imaginary because it's usually hard to see. I'm just going to wipe all inside, all around, and upside down. Because the more you wipe, the cleaner it gets. So I don't think it's necessary to keep buying Cricut sponges. Just because Cricuts aren't that important. They're a great part of and source of vitamins for your leopard gecko. But they're, I mean, not queens and kings here. So, now we have this. What are we going to do with this? Now, while this is over here, I have this. Let me just try to tilt that up so that you can see what I'm doing here. I'm sorry, guys. Alright, now in here, I'm basically going to turn this on and just try to wet all of the sides. And you're probably saying, what about the middle? What about all those places that didn't get wet? I have an answer for you. In about a second, I'm going to be right back. Alright, everybody. So my puppy Zoe came in, wanted to say hi to everybody. So I guess I let her. And here she is. So, yep, now time for her to go. And I got that thing we're going to need, which is that wonderful barbershop spray bottle. This is my tap water spray bottle. Zoe just went to the groomer today, so I know this is not her video, but yay, fluffiness. Bye, Zoe. All right, so now I've got that wonderful barbershop spray bottle. In this barbershop spray bottle, I pour tap water, and then I have another spray bottle that is basically used for all my animals, spraying Chloe's, my leopard gecko's hide. And because this is my tap water one, so I use it for unimportant things. This is cool. You guys want to spray? Nope, I'm not damaging my camera. I know it's summer, you may be hot where you are. But as you can see, I just spray all around. And basically, there's really nowhere that doesn't get sprayed. So in those areas, any areas you can't get a spray bottle can always help do that. You can also adjust the nozzle to make it squirt. And that one is actually brand new and it's actually getting messed up right now. Of course, we get our paper towels and dry that thing up. Now our Crickets are waiting this whole time. So you can't be, I'm doing this slow to show you guys, but you can't be slow. Because from the drive home or the bus ride home or the walk home from your pet store, however close your pet store is to you, those Crickets are waiting from the time they're in the store. They're waiting from the time they're in, from the time they're getting shipped to the pet store. They're waiting. So they're always waiting. And then you bring them home in this plastic bag and they're still waiting. So the longer you wait, the less excited they are, the more stress you have on them. So now I think it's good enough and clean enough. I would put the top on, but I'm going to let the top air dry a bit. And now we have that wonderful thing that we need to, I'm sorry guys, we have that wonderful that wonderful placement job to do. And I forgot my scissors, so I'll be right back once again. Alright everyone, so you might have been saying, why do I need scissors in that short 1 second break? I need scissors because this paper towel hide is pretty long. And it needs to be cut appropriately. No, we're not making Rocky's bird toy, but that could be something you could do. Out of the ordinary at with this. I see the inside of this is wet. And inside, a wet inside of a Cricut's cage is basically asking for spoilage. And it's basically asking for Cricut's to drown and you wasted your 10 cent per Cricut at like they do it where I live. At PetSmart. Yeah. So basically now that's pretty dry. I'm going to take my Cricut, my water bottle hides. These water bottle hides get wet, and they already were all wet, but I wanted you to just see that, how you'd wet them. But I do it in a stack. So now I dry them. But they've mostly been dry this whole time. And now I'm just going to place them. But first, so number one, place these hides down. And I usually do one on each side of the cage, as you can see. Now you're going to place these down. One goes here. One goes here. Hold on, I'm sorry. Some of them aren't dry, so I'm going to have to do the drying process. Another one here. I'm sorry, guys. Another one here. And I think I have another one. If I didn't get another one, usually there's one smack down in the middle. Nope, I didn't get another one. Sorry. But usually, oh, yes, I did get another one. See, I know. I'm smart. I knew. I needed it. But it's really great to have one smack down in the middle because that's basically the center. And in that, I always put water. Cricket water. Why use cricket water? If you use regular water, it's basically asking for crickets to drown. Crickets cannot drink out of regular water because it's too liquidy for them. So, if you don't want your crickets to drown, don't place them in water. So basically, I can put some of that in there. Basically, this is a cricket food bowl, or a cricket water bowl, rather. I have three waters and two foods. So I'm gonna get some more water. I have a water on each side and again smack down in the middle. Whew. So one just fell and that's okay because when water gets everywhere it's sort of good. Because then if a cricket's making his way to water and can't survive and is right near that water and can't make it, that water could have saved him and saved me 10 cents and saved cricket. Save my gecko Chloe some time for me to get more crickets. Alright, guys, so. Alright, so now you see that the whole setup is basically complete. You see that basically complete besides the food. Now we have cricket food. Now, this is cricket diet. This is the food. It's basically a powder, and I heard once on YouTube, I'm not sure who that actually was, heard it years ago, moths were in this. So be careful. Read the expiration date for things that can fly out of it. Mine's is on 2013. Hopefully that focuses for you. Well, it's February 2013. Sorry why it's not focusing, I don't know why. Alright, so 2013 is the expiration date on that. And 2013 as well, but March. On the cricket water. Now, I have this. This is leopard gecko food. Bought this one day thinking, oh my god, why don't I get my gecko some leopard gecko food? Not thinking that Chloe wasn't going to like this, not thinking that Zoomed was trying to get my money, and they got it. This, my leopard gecko doesn't like. It's basically a combination of different types of flies. And my gecko doesn't eat flies. Its ingredients is small laboratory-raised flies. I don't know why this is not focusing. Well, I'm sorry, guys. Natural flavoring. Vitamin mix, all that stuff. And it says feeding. Okay, so quickly, I'm just going to let you guys know, because I'm running out of time on my camera, you're supposed to feed this 4 to 5 times a week as needed, and slightly mix the food with water, it says, to reactivate the flavoring if your gecko does not eat after the first day. My gecko didn't eat after, like, the 10th day. So I wind up saying, if my gecko doesn't like it, crickets are what you feed them, so I'm going to feed my crickets this. And if the crickets actually do eat this, it's pretty nasty because they're basically eating another insect. Yeah, so I basically pour only one bowl has this. This is pretty nasty. Sorry. Because it is just bugs. But the other bowl has all those good stuff in it. But the water is basically what the crickets like more. And that's because after a long trip home, they need that water. It's just like the water is what they really need after that trip. Oh, goodness gracious. All right, so now I'm going to put the food. That's what the food looks like. And you got to refill the food in the water as it leaves. I refill it as it leaves. I don't refill it. And I don't know if this, some people do this, but I do not. And I will never in my life, I don't think, and take the crickets out to clean the cage. Because it says clean weekly, and if the crickets aren't gone after a week, because I feed mealworms and waxworms sparingly, as they are basically junk food and high in fat. Alright, so now we're going to get an overview. But I don't clean my crickets cage every week. I clean it after the crickets are done. So you have an overview. You have food and water. You have your water smack down in the middle. You have your paper towel hide, your other paper towel hide, your leopard gecko food, and your water. That's all, and now we're going to place the crickets in. Alright, so now the crickets are going in. This is basically dry. Okay, so as you heard, I said it's basically dry. That meant I need to dry it again. So that's what I did. And make sure that this is always tight. You don't want any crickets getting out. So now I'm going to open this. And this is where I put in the crickets. So I'm going to show you guys that. Here they are. The little critters. Alright, so here this is. Nice and crickety. I'm quickly going to untie the rubber band. I don't necessarily cut it. I basically untie it. Because you don't want to cut any plastic or anything so the crickets get out. And you want to be very careful how you do this. I've done this countless times, so I sort of know what I'm doing. But every time it's different. You don't want any crickets to get out into your house. When I first got my leopard gecko, I think some crickets got out. We had found them. When I first got my leopard gecko, but that was because I wasn't too experienced. And I hope this video is showing you that you do need to take your time now that it's open. You want to make sure your hand is here. Press tightly. Do not press lightly. If you press tightly, the crickets cannot escape from through here. So now, I apologize. All right. So now I'm basically taking this, and the crickets do not know what's about to happen. So they're just going to fall out. Alright? You want to make sure... Oh, sorry. I am extremely sorry. This is really bad. Alright, so... You want to let that flatten out. You want to make sure that all parts are in. And then you want to simply let shake. Alright, now I slam this down. Any crickets that have not got in by now, I feel sorry for them. I want to get you guys down to a better view here as the crickets are getting to know their brand new home. You can see some are coming out of there. There are crickets all over. Getting water, as I said. That water that actually fell is a great place for crickets to get stopped by water. Then you have some crickets over here getting water. Right now the crickets are all over the place. Yeah, so they're all over right now. I'm gonna let you look at that. Hope it doesn't gross you out. It is basically science. I'm just going to pull this because I need to make sure. I want to show you guys the confirmation check that all crickets have entered the bag safely. I basically check this. I clear down and I make sure that there are no crickets in here. Now, check the bottom. Don't see any crickets. And I'm going to slowly pull. So that any crickets that are in here will simply come right out. Now, because I might be blind today, I might not know that there was a cricket in here. I'm going to simply take this bag, hold it like this, close it, put a knot in it. And after that, you should be fine. So, any crickets that are in there are basically going to continue being dead. That's all. Thank you for watching. Comment, rate, subscribe. And since you guys haven't got those of you who requested those diets and leopard gecko stuff, like got diets and cleaning the tanks, this is sort of how to clean a tank dealing with leopard geckos. It's cleaning your cricket tank. And this is what leopard geckos eat. Maybe I'll have a... Oh, gosh, I'm sorry, guys. Maybe I'll have a feeding video up soon. And of the crickets being fed to Chloe. And I'm sorry that those requests haven't came out. But here you have something to hold you over until those requests are fulfilled. Thank you guys so much for watching. Comment, rate, subscribe. I hope you enjoyed today's sort of cricket show. And thanks for watching once again. I hope you enjoyed this vid, and that's all. If you want to see the crickets one more time, you can sort of see them over there. Yep, but that's all. Hope you enjoy this Professional Pets. And since this is Professional Pets, we always like to say, Professional Pets, always be professional.